How often should I reset my PC? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. And to be clear, I'm real, I'm not AI. On top of that, every video, including this one, comes with a handcrafted human written article to go along with it. This video's article is at askleo.com/185905. So, resetting your PC involves backing everything up, reinstalling Windows and applications from scratch, and then restoring your data from the backup or somewhere else. In years past, I've actually recommended doing this fairly regularly. Recommending an annual reset wasn't uncommon for active users, including myself. These days, a reset isn't really as necessary as it once was. So I'll review why and when we might want to reset Windows. So why are we talking about resetting at all? Well, like any modern operating system, Windows is unfathomably complex. Over time, Windows becomes slightly less stable. As updates are applied, old components are replaced, software is installed, software is uninstalled, configurations are changed, malware is discovered and removed, and so on, the internal state of the system gets, for lack of a better term, messier. Now, some of it is under Windows control, but much is at the mercy of third-party software, like the drivers and the applications you install. Symptoms are subtle. They range from the system just feeling slower than it once was, to applications, including Windows, not behaving as they should, to random crashes and other issues. A reset starts over with a clean slate, and that whole process begins again. Now, none of that has really changed. What has changed is that the rate of degradation has decreased fairly dramatically. These days, it's actually reasonable to assume that for a casual user, the operating system will remain stable enough throughout the life of the computer itself. A reset, of sorts, I suppose, happens when the device itself is actually replaced. But sometimes, particularly for active users who stress their systems in various ways, such as installing and uninstalling lots of different software, a reset might be called for before the computer's replacement. So, great. How often? Well, unfortunately, there's just no hard and fast answer to how often you should reset your PC. Like I said, it's very possible you may never need to. I'll use myself as an example. I used to count on a reset roughly once a year. As you can imagine, I'm a heavy user. I play with a lot of different things. I test an assortment of even more. I definitely consider myself at the far end of that bell curve. And yet, I've reset my current desktop, the 5.5-year-old desktop as I record this, exactly once, about a year ago. Which means that was over 4.5 years without a reset. Now, your mileage will definitely vary. Rather than looking at a specific time frame, base it on your system's performance. At some point, its behavior will reach some threshold, and it'll just feel like it's not the machine that it once was. That's a prime time to consider a reset. Now, there are some other times. Besides feeling that your machine has slowed down or become unstable, there are a few other times when it's at least worth considering a reset. Rather than being driven by explicit concerns, these are opportunities to reset the clock. So, if you're thinking about replacing your machine, take a minute to see if it's really as bad or slow or as incapable as you think it is. Whatever's driving you to consider replacement is also an opportunity to see if your existing machine might feel like a replacement after a reset. While certainly not guaranteed, there are just too many variables, it can save you a lot of time and money when it works. And let's face it, getting a new machine incurs many of the same costs as a reset. You still have to reinstall all your applications and restore and/or move your data. The other option is recovering from malware I'm constantly amazed at the time people spend trying to remove malware from their computers. They'll spend hours or days downloading assorted tools, running scans, following sketchy advice, all without a guarantee that the malware is actually removed. Aside from restoring an image backup taken before the malware arrived, a reset is quicker. It's also guaranteed to remove the offending malware. And as a bonus, your machine gets to start over with a clean slate. Now, I don't mean to imply that performing a reset is some kind of magical silver bullet that will suddenly fix all the problems you've been having with Windows or whatever, but it'll fix a lot of them. I also realize that how Windows performs changes over time. A clean install of the Windows operating system from, say, 4 years ago will behave differently, faster or slower, than a clean install of today's Windows, even the same version, say 10 or 11. That's the nature of software development over time. But removing the accumulation of cruft? Well, that's always a good thing. Bottom line, don't plan on a regular schedule for resets. Instead, keep it in mind as your system performance degrades over time or some of the other opportunities for a reset arise. And it's entirely possible that, yeah, you may never need to do one. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/185905. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.